Hello friends, so today in this lecture we will discuss about machine learning algorithms. So in this lecture we will cover some topics like what is machine learning, why we need machine learning, so what is machine learning algorithm, what are different types of machine learning algorithms, for example supervised learning, unsupervised learning, reinforcement learning. So all these learning methods, algorithms will be discussed here with some suitable examples. Now, just see the background behind the machine learning algorithms. So the idea is, can we design such a machine which can also learn like a human being? How the human learns? Human learns by examples. For example, if we talk about a kid who does not know what is alphabet A, what is alphabet B. So how he does come to know, how he comes to know about these alphabets? The teacher teaches him or her by giving some examples. Okay, just see, this is alphabet A, this is alphabet B. And based on those examples provided by his teacher, the kid is able to learn about the alphabets. What is alphabet A, what is alphabet B? And once he learns, anybody can ask, okay, he can ask about the alphabet, and the kid is able to recognize that alphabet. So this is how, as a kid learns by examples, can we design such a machine also which can learn like a human, like a kid. So these things would be covered in this topic. So these are the agendas for today's session. So what is machine learning? What is machine learning algorithm? Need for machine learning? What are different types of machine learning algorithms? So supervised learning, unsupervised learning, reinforcement learning. So all these learning methods will be discussed with some examples over here, and other things also. So now, what is machine learning? So this term has coined first by Arthur Samuel in 1959. So machine learning is what? Machine learning is a concept which allows the machine to learn from examples and experience, and that too without being explicitly programmed. So we don't have to write down a program explicitly to learn, but these algorithms are itself capable to learn itself in order to find out the pattern, in order to recognize the problem. So this is what the machine learning is. The example is learning by the kids, the student teacher learning, where the teacher talks about the topic, teachers give some examples, teachers try to explain the topic, and basically by giving some examples, question and answers, and the students are being able to learn with those examples. So this kind of method is also called machine learning. And self-learning also, a bookish study. From the student itself learns from the book, itself learn from the material, online material, soft copy and hard copy material. So this machine learning would be better understood by some examples. For example, you have been asked to choose the best apples. So how can you choose the best apples? So you will search out some rules. So for example, if you ask to write down a program to search best apple, so you will write something like this: if the apple color is bright red and if size is big, then apple is sweet. And another rule is, if it is crispy, then apple is juicy. So basically these rules are required to be known to you in order to write down a program to find out the best apples. But this is not sufficient enough. So any fruit or any object may have numerous amount of features. So you have to consider those features also in order to get the perfect answer. This is actually the issue for this kind of problem. So but every time you make a new observation, what if you had to choose oranges instead from experiments? You have to modify the list of rules manually. So this is another problem. If you want to choose some other fruit instead of apples, like oranges, guavas, mangoes, so definitely you have to change the rules these rules, whatever the rules you have written for the Apple, you have to change that rule also. So these are the two different issues. First is to understand the details of all factors affecting the quality of the fruit. And the second is, it is difficult to make accurate rules by hand that covers all possible types of the fruits. So basically, these two things will take a lot of research and effort. And finally, this is the where the machine learning algorithms come into the picture. So how it helps out from these kind of issues? Machine learning, how it helps us in overcoming these kind of issues? So instead of writing your own code, just like previously I have discussed, what you do is you feed the data to the machine learning algorithms, and the algorithm or machine builds the logic based on the given data. So you don't need to write the extra code to find out the pattern, to find out the features from the data set, but this machine learning algorithm itself is able to find out the pattern, find out the features, find out the logic based on the given data. So that is the beauty of machine learning. So it is an evolution of regular algorithm. It makes your programs smarter by allowing them to automatically learn from the data you provide. So basically, the machine learning algorithms has two different phases, the training phase and the testing phase. So suppose we have a certain data set. So out of that data set, some data set is picked up for the training purpose, and the remaining data set is used for the testing purpose. So in general, the people, 70% data is used. Whatever the data is available for you, the 70% data is used for the training, and the remaining 30% data is used for the testing purpose. So what happens? The 70% data will be provided to the machine learning algorithms. Machine learning algorithms itself will be able to find out the logic, find out the rules from the data set, and it will create a model. Once a model is created, now it is being ready to test. To test whether the model is how much model is efficient. So the remaining 30% data set will be inputted to this model in order to check whether it is giving the correct results or not. So if suppose it is giving 90% correct results, then we can say that the machine learning model, whatever we have built here, that has 90% efficiency. So in case it makes a wrong prediction, so it will update its rule by itself. The best part of this is you can use the same algorithm to train different models. So this is the beauty of machine learning algorithm. The same algorithms can be used for different kind of problems. For example, here, if you want to you choose any kind of fruits, it may be guava, it may be mango, it may be banana, it may be anything else. So the same algorithm can be used for all those types of the problems over here. So this is the beauty of machine learning. So the next is the need for machine learning. Why we need machine learning? We know that day by day we have a large amount of data set available, and we want to analyze those data set. We want to find out some useful pattern from that data set in order to for the analysis, in order to get some benefits. For example, the large organizations, they are working on to analyze the large amount of data set in order to increase their profits, in order to create a good satisfaction to their employees, in order to reduce the risk, the incoming risk in their business. So all these kind of applications that we need are the machine learning algorithms, because machine learning algorithms are such an algorithms which can work on large amount of data, and it can itself able to find out the patterns, itself able to find out the rules from the data set. So as per research, we generate around 2.5 quintillion bytes of data every single day. So we need to build the predictive models that can study and analyze complex data to find useful insights and deliver more accurate results. So this is what the machine learning is required. There are so many other companies also here. The two companies, Netflix and Amazon, they have built such machine learning models by using tons of the data in order to identify profitable opportunities and avoid unwanted risks. So this is where the need for machine learning comes into picture. Now the next is, we can better understand what is the importance of machine learning is. So Netflix recommendation engine is built by machine learning algorithms, which recommend you a movie which is your favorite movie, which is based on your interest of movies. So similarly, the Facebook auto tagging features, you all already know that if you are posting some photographs where multiple photos are present, so if any photo is matching with your friend list, any friend of your friend list, so it automatically tag with that friend. So this is the beauty of Facebook's auto tagging features. This is possible because of the machine learning algorithms. Now the third is Amazon's Alexa. So it is infamous Alexa, which is based on natural language processing and machine learning. It is an advanced level of virtual assistant that does more, just plays songs on your playlist. So basically, based on your interest, so it plays a song, automatically plays a song from your playlist, Amazon Alexa. It can also book your Uber car. It can also connect with other IoT devices at home. It can track your health, etc. Another important example is Google's spam filter, that is also built by machine learning algorithms, which automatically finds out the spam emails from your emails, and it avoids you to disturb you, and it sends it in a spam folder, and it automatically deleted from that folder. It does not disturb the user. So these are some examples. There are so many more examples are there, but these are some examples which tells us the importance of machine learning algorithms. So these are the types of machine learning algorithms, basically three types: supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement. In supervised learning, the examples are regression models. So regression, linear regression, and polynomial regression, the decision tree, the random forest, and the classification. There are k nearest neighbor, the trees-based classification, then logistic regression, the neighbor-based classification, then support vector machine. So all these are examples of supervised learning. Unsupervised learning, the clustering comes. In clustering, single value decomposition, principal component analysis, k-means clustering, hierarchical clustering, DB scan, so many examples are there for clustering. Then association analysis, a priori analysis, and FP growth analysis, and then the hidden Markov model. And the third is the reinforcement learning. So basically, these examples of supervised and unsupervised learning can be classified into two different continuous data and the categorical data. So above three examples in supervised learning, they work on continuous data, means numerical value data, while the rest of the other classification, these are the methods, basically they work on the categorical data, where we talk about a yes or no, or kind of categorical kind of data. So next is, what is supervised learning? So basically, supervised learning means a learning which is done by a supervisor, with the help of supervisor. So when a machine learns by some supervisor, that learning is called supervised learning. For example, student teacher learning is example of supervised learning. Why? Because teacher acts as a supervisor. Teacher gives some examples. Teacher talks about the topic. Teacher gives some question and answers. So basically, teacher acts as a supervisor and students are being able to learn. So this is an example of supervised learning. So supervised learning is a technique in which we teach or train the machine using data which is well labeled. So just see here, if a teacher does not give examples with labeled data, means he will ask questions and he will also give answers, then only the students will be able to learn. So basically, if we have a set of questions and we have corresponding answers, we can say that we have a labeled data, means we have input and corresponding, and we have also corresponding output. So we have a labeled data set, and that labeled data set acts as a supervisor to make learn of any topic to the students. So the process of algorithm learning from the training data set can be thought of as a teacher teaching his students. So whatever the training data set is provided, that acts as a teacher, that acts as a supervisor. The algorithm continuously predicts the result on the basis of training data and continuously corrected by the teacher. This is how the supervised learning performs. So the teacher, what teacher does, it gives some examples, it gives some results, and then basically as a training data set, and then every time the student makes to learn, and it is refined, it is continuously refined, it is continuously corrected, and after a certain time the model is built with certain efficiency. Now this model is ready to for the testing. The learning continues until the algorithm achieves an acceptable level of performance. So the learning continues until we get good performance. So every instance of the training data set consists of input attributes. So what kind of input attributes provided to the model? So it can be a database row, it can be the pixels of the image, it can be even an audio frequency histograms, and it can be a weather parameters, it can be a diagnostic parameters and an expected output. So examples of supervised learning is biometric attendance. So in first we build a model. Suppose if there are 100 employees in an organization, so first we build a model for all those 100 employees. We take biometrics. If it is a fingerprint based biometric, so we take fingerprints for all the employees. So employee 1 has biometric 1, employee 2 has biometric 2. So these are the labeled data set provided to the model. Now model is learned. Model is learned by the machine learning algorithms. Now it is ready. Now it is ready to test for testing purpose. So it is now placed in the front office of the organization. Similarly, for the pre-screening diagnostic tool, so initial level, we just find out to the characteristics of any problem disease if the person is suffering from. Then the other is the weather forecast system. So these are the examples of the weather forecast system. So we build the model by just providing the weather parameters, previous old parameters, and we'll just see what kind of parameters are responsible for the particular weather. And then once that model is built, now it is able to predict for the any new input. So all kids, we needed guidance to solve the math problems. Our teachers have us understand what addition is and how it is done. The labeled data set is the teacher that will train you to understand the patterns in the data set. So labeled data set basically is whatever the training data set you provide to the model. Just here in this figure, we have two different kind of data input data set, which is labeled data. Just see here, labeled means first kind of image is basically labeled with Tom, and second kind of image is labeled with yellow color with Jerry. Just see here, we have two different kind of labeled data set over here, and we are providing certain examples to our model here. Here we do some initial data operations like data cleaning, then we pass it to the algorithms, then machine learning algorithms, then it gives some output, then this output is being evaluated with some examples, and we just see here if any unknown input is given to this model, so it is being able to classify into two classes. First class is Jerry, and the second class is the Tom, based on its features. So we don't have to provide the features, external or internal features of the object. This machine learning algorithm itself able to find out the pattern, itself able to find out the rule, and based on those rules, it is able to classify whether it is the image of Jerry or it is the image of Tom. So this is how supervised learning works. Now, unsupervised learning, there is no any supervisor. We don't require any teacher. We don't have any supervisor here. So how it performs learning? So unsupervised learning involves training by using unlabeled data set and allowing the model to act on that information without guidance. So this kind of learning is being used when we don't have labeled data set. We don't know which image is for Tom and which image is for Jerry. But we just provide a collection of
data to the model, and this algorithm, unsupervised learning based algorithm, itself being able to find out the pattern, and based on those patterns, it is able to classify whether this is image, these images are for a particular level 1, and the other images are for particular level 2. Just see here in this example, here we have the unlabeled data set, input data set. These pictures are not being labeled as a Tom or Jerry. We just have to provide the collection of images to this model, and this model is being able to learn, and based on its internal features, that is actually being decided by the unsupervised learning algorithms, and based on its internal or external features, itself able to classify into two different classes. Just see here the three similar images, pictures of one animal is grouped into one class and other group into another class. So this is how the unsupervised learning works. So think of as unsupervised learning as a smart kid that learns without any guidance. So a kid is, for example, a student who learns without help of a teacher from books or from the study material available in internet. So this kind of learning is unsupervised. There is no any teacher. The student is self able to learn from the topic by reading, by study the topic, by study the chapter of the book. So now the third is, what is reinforcement learning? So it can be thought of like a hit or trial method of learning. So we don't have any information, any kind of information about the data set. So we have suddenly given the data set, and we have to find out the pattern from the data set. That is what the reinforcement learning. This basically works on reward and penalty based concept. This machine gets a reward or penalty point for each action it performs. If the option is correct, the machine gains the reward point or gets a penalty point in case of a wrong response. So it is all about the interaction between the environment and the learning agent. The learning agent is based on exploration and exploitation. These are the two important points which are being used in this learning. So exploration is what? Exploration is when the learning agent acts as on the trial and error basis, and exploitation is what? When it performs an action based on the knowledge gained from the environment. So exploration is what? Suppose it can be better understand by some examples. Suppose a person imagine that you were dropped off an isolated Iceland. So what would you do? So if you are dropped off an isolated Iceland where you don't know what kind of weather over there, what kind of water over there, whether water is useful for drinking or not, whether what kind of food is available over there, you don't know anything about the Iceland. You have been put into that Iceland. So what do we do? So you will panic. Yes, of course, initially we will all would, but as time passes by, you will learn how to live on that Iceland. So as time passes by, so you will learn, okay, how you can sustain over there, how you can live over there, how can you make your life over there by taking your own actions over there. So you will explore the environment, understand the climate condition and the type of food that grows there and the dangers of the Iceland. So all these things you will explore yourself. So first you explore, then based on the knowledge you obtain from the environment, you will exploit, you will utilize those knowledge, and you will utilize those resources available over there. So this is exactly how the reinforcement learning works. So it involves an agent. You are stuck on the Iceland, and this is put an unknown environment, Iceland, where he must learn by observing and performing action. The result is reward. So when it is rewarded, then you will repeatedly perform that action. If you are getting penalty, so you will not again perform that action. So basically, it works on reward and penalty based concepts. Thank you very much. This is the end of first lecture.